And after their summit, President Moon, together with the leaders of the five Mekong countries, attended a special exhibition on what they've achieved together in terms of research on and conservation of biological resources. Kim Mok-yeon tells us more.
On the sidelines of the first Mekong-Korea summit, a special exhibition on the biological resources of the Mekong region has been held to look back at the past 12 years of cooperation between South Korea and the Mekong states in the biological sector. Under the theme Life on the Mekong, Connecting People, Creating a New Future, the exhibition features various videos and real specimens of the rich flora and fauna of the Mekong region, as well as achievements of cooperative projects between Mekong nations and South Korea. On display are some 200 species of wildlife from the Mekong region, including donated specimens from each Mekong country, as well as biological resources secured through joint research and illustrated books jointly published by researchers in the region. South Korean President Moon Jae-in toured by the exhibition hall together with the heads of the Mekong states, and during his joint press statement after the tour, he vowed to help preserve the biodiversity of the Mekong region and support the region's efforts to have a sustainable future.
우리는 메콩강 유역을 둘러싼 초국경 위협에 공동 대응하고 생물 다양성, 수자원, 산림 분야 협력을 강화하기로 했습니다.
President Moon also said the countries will establish the Mekong-Korea Biodiversity Center and the Mekong-Korea Water Resources Joint Research Center to better conserve and utilize biological resources and work together to ensure the sustainability of the Mekong River. The National Institute of Biological Resources, the host of the event, says that it hopes the displays could help visitors gain more interest and learn about the biodiversity in the Mekong region. The special exhibition will be open to the public from November 30th to December 27th. Kim Mok-yeon, Arirang News, Busan.